Welcome to WatchGuard Security Byte. I'm Corey Knockreiner, and today's story is a VR app vulnerability. First of all, if you watch this video, you might know that I like to sometimes mix my personal hobbies and interests with information security. And while it's not a Friday video today, I'm doing that nonetheless, because today's story is about one of my big latest interests, virtual reality. Which means, by the way, if you're not a VR user, this is probably not a practical video for you, though it might be interesting. However, this is actually a pretty big deal for VR users that use PC VR. In any case, researchers from the University of New Haven released vulnerabilities that affect a VR application called BigScreen, as well as also affect the Unity development platform. Now, if you don't have VR or you don't know what the BigScreen app is, it's kind of a VR app that gives you a virtual home or a virtual environment where you can, one, display your computer screen in virtual reality just to do work, or you can like watch media and videos in your private virtual reality environment, and you can even collaborate with friends. You can invite friends to this VR room, and all of you can kind of socially engage in media content or collaborate or sharing your screen or other interesting stuff like that. It's actually a pretty cool social VR app. However, the University of New Haven researchers found a pretty serious set of vulnerabilities in it. Without going into any technical detail, which they haven't really posted yet, they show a video where if they can set up a command and control server in the BigScreen's main lobby, which is where users kind of first congregate before they move to either public or private rooms, they can then infect any user that actually joins that lobby. Once they infect that user, they're able to follow that user around. If the user sets up a new room, even if it's a private room, they can actually join that user's private room, and they can do so invisibly. So that means if you're in a private room with your other VR friends, there could be another VR user lurking in there without you knowing. And that's just the beginning. They can also do things like turn on your microphone so that they can eavesdrop into any conversations you're having specifically in the room, or even having at home in your own privacy. They can see your desktop and actually control some of the capabilities of BigScreen. Worse yet, they can actually even install programs on your computer without any interaction whatsoever by you. The only thing you do is join the BigScreen lobby, and you may not realize you're now infected, and a bad guy can install malware on your computer using a number of different techniques, in fact. Anyways, there's a number of different things the attacker can do. You've probably seen some of them in the university researcher's video, which I'm showing right now. But of course, the worst is just installing any malware that the user wants without you actually knowing. So this is a pretty big deal. And by the way, while they first found this in the BigScreen app, it actually is due to the Unity, the development platform that lots of different VR games use. So this is also a Unity flaw. That means if you're a Unity developer or if you have Unity on your own system, you may be vulnerable to this. Now, according to the researchers, they did disclose this privately before going public with it. And according to the BigScreen people, this is patched, though the researcher hasn't tested it. So if you are a VR user like me, in fact, one that owns BigScreen, you definitely want to make sure you're running the latest version. And if you use Unity, you might want to look into patching that as well. Anyways, that's it for this story. But in the future, it will be interesting to see if VR technology somehow exposes new attack surface to hackers. Now, in this case, know that it actually has little to do with VR. There's nothing specific in VR hardware that made this hack happen. This hack is really kind of just a traditional software vulnerability. It just happens to be in VR software specifically. So other than being a VR app, this isn't a specific VR vulnerability. That said, you never know how the technology will continue to evolve. So we may see hackers use VR in different ways. And in this particular case, it is actually interesting in how you can eavesdrop in a VR room. So you can watch other people interacting in VR without them knowing you're there. Anyways, that's it for today's story. Thank you for watching.